Hey nesters, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today, I'm gonna be telling you guys my rules for my future kids if I have any. So let's get started. Promise falling for me won't be a mistake. No, baby, this is not an illusion. Okay, so there's been this trend going around on TikTok kind of recently, and it's about, like, people are telling the rules about their future kids. And I could have done this on TikTok, but I decided I wanted to do it on here because I know what the video idea. And I just wanted to, so hope you guys enjoy. And also, I just want to say, do not make fun of me. I meant to say, don't judge me in the comment section for my rules. Like, these are just what I think and what I think are good rules. You guys can have your own opinions, you guys. You have your own rules. That's up to you and how you want to parent your kids in the future. These are just my opinions and my rules that I'm going to give to my kids if I have any in the future. So, yeah. And I found it. I'm template on TikTok, so I'm going to do it. So, and these are just in general, like, it's basically any age, but, like 11 and above, probably, are the ages. Okay, so for drugs, I would say they shouldn't do drugs at all unless they're 18, because at 18, they're an adult then, and I don't get to control them anymore. So, no drugs until you're 18. Okay. Alcohol. I would say don't drink it until you're legal, so that's 18 again. Are actually here in Canada, where I'm from right now, 19, and in the States it's 21, so I might be moving to the States, so until you're 21 or 19, if I stay here in Canada. So yeah, you're not probably gonna be able to drink it for a long time, because I wouldn't say underage drinking is good at all. So that's just my opinion. Yeah. And when you do drink it, I would say do not get drunk, but that is up to you. When you're 21 or you're 19, that is up to you, because you're an adult then and you make your own choices. But I would just say, don't drink underage. Even if you're partying or whatever, your friends are doing it, like, just, no. First of all, those aren't right friends if they're making you. But if you're just seeing them doing, they're not making you, but you're just seeing them, like, oh, that looks fun. Or you want to seem like you fit in. Just, no. Like, I would just be like, no, you shouldn't do that. But again, I can't really control that, because that might be out of my control, because they might do it off of my time when they're just on their own time without me. They're without their, you know, mom at the time, and they just do it. If I find out, they'd get in big trouble for it. Yes, they would. Okay, next one is sex. I would say you shouldn't have it at all until, like, you're older, because, you know, you could risk the chance of having a kid. Yes, if you wear condoms, you will be safe or whatever. But it doesn't fully prevent you. Like, it helps you, and you have less of a chance to have a kid, but you still could. So I would say don't have one until you're at least, like, don't have sex till later on. I don't really know the exact age, but I just wouldn't say to do it pretty young. I would say not at least until you're, like, 20, 19. Because if you do risk having a kid, at least you're not really, really young. I mean, that's still young to have a kid, but at least you're more. Like, at least until you graduate. Okay, piercings. I would say yes, have piercings wherever you want to have them. I would even let them have them on their nose or on their tongue or their belly button by the age of like 6, maybe like 14. Yeah, by the age of like 14, I would say you can have them wherever you want to have them. But I don't really like to have piercings anywhere else than your ear. But that's up to you. If you want to have them other places, that's fine. But when it comes to your ear, I can say you can have them like your, at least your very first one. You want to have it like when you're like a baby, because I'm going to get your first piercing when you're like really, really baby. And then when you get older, you're going to get more piercings when you're like 14. Well, actually, okay. You can get piercings on your ear, like normal piercings on your ear when you're like 13. I mean, not 13, I meant to say when you're like 10. Yeah, when you're like 9 or 10. Actually, no, even like 8. Yeah, 8. When you're like 8, you can get them on your ear. I wouldn't care, but when you're like, I'm really young, I'm gonna get you like your first one, but then later on, if you wanna get more on your ear, you can get them when you're like 8. But then, or older if you don't, you wanna wait, but you can get them at 8 at the earliest. And then when you're older, like you're like 14, then you can get them anywhere else, like your nose or anywhere else. But I just wouldn't say getting them anywhere else when you're that young. Okay, next one, tattoos. Don't get one until you're able to, and I don't know the age, I think it's 18, so yeah. And don't call me a strict mom. Maybe, like, oh my god, you're so strict. Like, why do you have to make us wait? I'm just wanting to follow the rules and do what's right. Because I don't think it's right to do things when you're not actually the age. You know what I'm saying? So, okay, relationships. Okay, for relationships, I would say you're allowed to have a relationship, but I would say you have to be like at least like 14 or 15 years old till you start your first relationship. Maybe I would say 13, maybe 12. But in like a very serious relationship, I would say 14 or 15. But a more like just like, you know, kind of like, okay, sorry. That are just like kids. Because when you're really young, you're just like a kid, you know what I'm saying? So it'd be kind of weird. Like have like a real relationship, like if you're just friends and you kind of like hang out, it's like the opposite gender, whatever. That is fine as long as I don't see you like do more than just like hang out. You know what I'm saying? Like you might like, you know, you can flirt with the person or like be extra like, I don't know. I guess it's flirty or whatever. But I wouldn't want you guys to be kissing or you can hold hands, but not kissing or you know, touching them sexually or you know, having sex. Like I said, but if you're just doing that. Then that's fine. But when you get older, like 14 or 15, when you get like to 14 or 15, in a more serious relationship, you can do whatever, like kids, go on dates by yourself. You don't need me with you, parents with you. But when you're like younger and you're in a relationship or relationship, I would need to be with you at all times. So if you go somewhere, you need at least a parent, it can be their parent or my parent, just someone who's an adult. If they have siblings that are older and they're adults, they can bring those. But they just have to be a legal adult that can take care of you while you guys are home. If you're younger than 14. Okay. Or 13. Yeah, younger than, no, I'm gonna say 14, yeah. Okay, next one. For a serious relationship. Okay. Next one, sports. I would say yes, I would let you guys go in sports as long as I have the money to pay for it for you. But yes, that's a really good thing. I think sports are amazing. You can make a lot of great friends in sports. Like some of people's best friends come with sports. So yes, I would encourage that. As long as I have the money, me or my husband, whoever I end up marrying, if I do marry someone, well, I would if I had kids. But anyway, if we have the money to pay for it, then yes, you can do sports. And I would say you do as many as you want to do, as long as you have the money for all the ones you want to do. But I would, it depends how many kids we have too, but I would say like two sports per kid at the most, because it'd probably be way more money if I did more than that. So you'd have to pick at least two that you can play. Maybe more if I had money, but I'm just gonna say two because I don't think I'd have more money for more than that. But especially since I kind of want to have like at least four kids. So, anyway, next one, college. Okay, so I would say you don't have to go to college like when you're older. You can make your own decision if you want to go to college or not. But with that being said, if you're not going to college, you would need a job. At least you can't just be sitting around in the house all the time doing nothing. Like, at least have a job, you know, be like responsible and doing something with your life, not just lazing around all day. It can be a part-time job, I wouldn't care, but just have a job. And yeah, but if you're going to college and you're like going to college full-time, you won't need a job, but you could still have a job if you're in college. That's up to you if you want to when you're in college. If you think you can manage having a job, then have one. But if you're not going to college, I would, meh. Even though you're older and you're an adult now, I would still really, really want you to have a job. Okay. Grades. Well, when it comes to grades, I wouldn't like be very hard on the person for grades because as long as I know you're trying your best, I wouldn't care. But if I knew you could do better and I knew that like something was distracting, like you know, your phone or you know, video games or whatever, or hanging with friends all the time, and you just don't do your work, you don't try, then I'd get a little upset. But if I knew that you were actually trying your best and you just your best wasn't really that good, I guess you would say. Like it was like a C or something, and that was your best, and then I would just be, I'd be happy with that. I'd be like, great, as long as you're not failing. So yeah, that's on that. Okay, next one, parties at our house. I would say no. As long as we're home, and we know, or like you call us and let us know if we're not home, and say, oh, can I have a party? Then maybe I would say yes if you did everything right and you make sure you clean up after the people. You don't wreck the house. Nothing happens in the house. It's all safe and fine. Yes, I would say that's fine. But don't just have one without our permission. And don't just throw it just because, oh, we're out. We're going to have one. Like, no, I'm going to probably most likely allow you if you just ask. And make sure that nothing bad happens. And if your first party you ever have at our house doesn't go well, then I probably wouldn't let you have a party again. But that's only you have to show me proof that you were able to have a party without wrecking anything in the house or doing any damage. You know what I'm saying? So that's on that. And you can have as many people as you want as long as, you know, nothing happens in the house. That's all. And you can even do it when we're home too. I wouldn't care. But I know most of the time you wouldn't want us to be home, so when we're not home, you just have to ask us. Call and ask. Okay, chores. Okay, so I would say you would have to be doing chores. Like, I'll pay you up and, like, from, like, when you're, like, turn, like, 8, I would say. Maybe a little younger, actually, like, maybe, like, 6, 7. Yeah, like, 7. 7 and above, you would have to do chores, but until you get a job. If you get a job, then you don't have to do chores anymore. But, I mean, you still should help out around the house, but you're not going to be getting paid anymore for the chores. I mean, there will still be things that you should do, but, you know, you're not going to get paid for them. But when you're, like, younger and you don't have a job yet, then the chores, you're going to start doing them at 7. More than you don't have to do any chores. I mean, I would still say you should still do some, like, cleaning up your toys or whatever if you're playing. But you won't have, like, specific actual chores until, like, 7. And then, until you get a job. And then once you get a job, you won't really have chores anymore, but it's just, like, you should help out. And, like, you should just do your part in the house because, you know, you're older and, you know, you just should do that. But you won't be getting paid once you have a job. Okay, next one, sexuality. Honestly, sexuality, I don't really care. Do whatever you want. I'm going to be supportive no matter what. If you come out to me, I would love that. And I really want to be that person. Like, I want to be the parent that's very, like, I don't know the word, like, supportive of you. When you're able, you're not afraid to come to me to ask me anything or to tell me anything. Like, we can talk to me. You can talk to me and feel comfortable coming to me and telling me any of your problems you're going through, anything you want. Just want to, like, I want to be that type of parent that's very, like, accepting and I listen to you and let you tell me whatever you want to tell me. So if you did come out to me, I wouldn't care. I would love you for who you are. And yeah, that's just that. And a curfew. Well, if you go out and do stuff, I would want you to at least be home by, like, 10:30 or maybe, like, 11:30. Yeah, in between, like, 10:30 to 11. It depends who you're with and when the day is. Because if it's, like, a school night, I'd want you to be home probably by, like, 9. But you would never have here's another thing, too. This isn't on the list, but I'm going to talk about this, too. A bedtime. You never exactly have a bedtime. Like, before you're, like, 8, maybe you would have a bedtime. But then after that, you won't have a bedtime. And if you're going to bed super late on a school night, that would be your fault. And if you're tired the next day, well, too bad, too sad. I'm not going to come to you. You can't come to me and be like, oh, I want to miss school today. Like, no. You're never going to be able to miss school. So if you're tired, that's your fault. Don't blame me. Don't be like, you didn't give me a bedtime, so I'm tired. Like, no. You're the one who should be responsible enough to go to bed early so you're not tired. But if you don't do that, that's up to you. As long as you're not loud in your room, I don't care. I'll let you stay up. You can stay up, whatever. Even on a school night, I wouldn't care. But just with that being said, actually, I'm going to turn that off because it's done. With that being said, I don't want you guys to be getting mad at me or, you know, the kids to be like, to me, like, being like, oh my God, I'm so tired. Can I stay home from school? Like, no, you're not staying home from school. You're still going to school. If you're tired, that is your fault for staying up too freaking late. And then when it comes to phones, that wasn't on there either. So, with phones, I would say you're allowed one at, like, maybe, like, 9 and above. And, yeah. Before that, you can get, like, iPads or iPods, like, from, like, ages, like, 4. You can have, like, an iPod or an iPad, whatever. And, yeah, social media, too. Like, you can have, when you get your first phone, like, before you have a phone, when you have an iPod or an iPad, like, 4 to 8, you shouldn't have social media. But 9 and above, I would let you have social media. I wouldn't care. Do whatever you want. I wouldn't monitor your phone at all. As long as I know where you are at all times, call me, let me know where you are. I'd be good with that. I wouldn't have to monitor your phone. Maybe if you're in trouble, I might take it away. No, actually, I probably wouldn't take away your phone. Your only thing you would probably get is you're in your room and you can't go hang out with anybody. You can't go to your friends or something. That'd be your punishment. You're still on your phone or your electronics. So it wouldn't be that much different if you didn't really have friends. But if you're the person who likes to go out and do stuff with your friend, it'd be kind of a big punishment. But for other people, it wouldn't really be a punishment. But it still kind of would be, because it would be like, you wouldn't even be allowed to go, like, out of your room at all. Like, even to come, you would only be allowed out if it was dinner. Or to, like, grab food, but, like, you wouldn't really be allowed to hang out with the family. Like, if we're, like, having a family dinner with me, sorry, you're in trouble. You can't even come out to hang out with the family or whatever. So that'd be kind of my punishment. I wouldn't really do much more than that. So yeah, this is kind of getting a little bit long, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Comment down below what you guys' rules would be for your kids. And I also want to be like that fun mom that hangs out with their kids, can kind of be like their friend in a way, but also know how to be like a parent and like be able to, you know, give them boundaries and stuff and discipline. Not like that bad of discipline, but just a little bit, like if they need it, whatever, just so they can, you know, learn things and grow up to be really great people. And yeah, just that's it. But I would be very, very like a chill parent, you know? Not strict at all, very chill, very fun. You know, if they wanted to go out and do something, I would take them out. You know, and like every once in a while, I'll take them out maybe on like a one-on-one day with like each kid. Like maybe like once a month, each kid would have a day. Every month maybe, or every 2 months. Something like that. And we would just go hang out, do whatever they want to do. As long as it's not like a lot of money. Like I'd be like, okay, there's a limit to how much money you can spend on this day. But like maybe you'd go out somewhere to like your favorite restaurant or whatever. And then maybe go to like a store and pick out like one toy or one, you know, like a piece of clothing. Depends on how old they are, whatever they want. And then, you know, if they want to go to the park, whatever, we'd go to the park. Or if they want to go to the beach that day, we'd go to the beach. Whatever it is, I'd let them choose. But yeah, that'd be that. So yeah, if you guys enjoy, and then also we do like a lot of stuff like the family, like all together, go out and like, and do stuff. Unless they didn't want it when they were hanging with their friends, then that's fine. Hang with your friend. I wouldn't force you to have family days. If you don't want to and you want to hang with your friend instead, that is fine. But with that being said, you do home at least sometimes. Okay, sorry, this is getting kind of long. Anyway, if you guys enjoyed it, give me a big thumbs up. I think I already said that. Comment down below what you guys' rules would be. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe to come in between. Bye, bye, guys.